Well, I'd say the inspiration started when I saw many years ago a documentary called Jesus Camp about children who were indoctrinated into evangelical Christianity and purity culture and the idea that men were superior to women and all that wonderful stuff. And then a few years later, I started watching the show on TLC, 19 Kids and Counting, about the since very controversial Deborah family. And something that was always struck me about that show was how they always idealized the family and the religion, and they never asked the hard questions, you know, like especially of the females in that family, you know, what it was like, you know, growing up. Did they ever feel like their opportunities were limited and things like that? Instead, they were focused more on, like, how many loads of laundry do you do in a week? You know, how do you feed your whole family? You know, how do you keep track of all your children in public? You know, so, like, the superficial things that didn't really matter. And then I started doing research on purity culture and, you know, really digging into evangelical Christianity and, you know, what it meant from to be in it and then also to be out of it, to be a survivor of that. And so I wanted to tell that story. I mean, I'm someone who's not really been raised with any kind of religion. So it was definitely a challenge to delve into this world as an outsider. And to even though it's a satire, to still be respectful to people who have survived it. And also I like the challenge of telling a story about a patriarchal culture in a way that passed the Bechdel test and didn't even involve any men.
What I love about Jeanette Rankin Fights Back is that I have the privilege and pleasure to speak words that Jeanette Rankin actually spoke. She was not a writer. She doesn't even have an official biography. She was a speaker. And that's pretty much who I am too. So I really enjoy having found specific things that she said to be able to quote her verbatim.
Tell the story that you want to tell and only the way that you can tell it. I think for me, like having a unique voice as a playwright is really important. Even if it's not for everybody, I know my particular style with puns and wordplay and rhyming. You know, not everybody likes that, but obviously you guys did, so thank you. just go for it. And, you know, as long as you're happy with your work, that's all that matters. As long as you know that what you wrote is good and that it deserves to be heard and put out there into the world, yeah, go for it. Don't let fear hold you back.
Yeah. I want them to be registering to vote, and I want them to be voting. I think the main message, not necessarily the main message of Jeanette's life, but the main message of Jeanette Rankin Fights Back is that in order to get the government that we want, we have to vote. And as she says, her whole life was determined by the votes she cast. And with the festival coming up in October, and with major elections ahead of us, everybody needs to register and everybody needs to vote.
I think that there are, you know, stories about women that only women can tell. I think there's definitely, you know, when you see a lot of, especially older plays written by men, that feature female characters. And there's something I noticed a lot, you know, running auditions. When people do monologues, women do monologues about females written by male-identifying people. And usually the women are crazy. And it's just a recurring theme. And I'm just like, this is what you chose? But that's what's available out there. You know, those apparently like, you know, meanie monologues feature women who are off their rockers, usually because of a man. And it just made me realize even more how important it is to have women telling their own stories.
You're here. For me, it's very important because we have been underserved. Women, including Jeanette Rankin, their voices have not been heard. And this is traditionally. And I think that most of the men that I know are not going to fault a women's theater festival, which I think is very important.
Listen.
I think this is a festival that really is going to, you know, be so diverse and inclusive intentionally, and is really going to, you know, vibrantly and valiantly validate the voices of so many women and really promote visibility.
I think from what I know already, and it's really not enough, this is going to be an amazing festival with huge diversity. The playwrights are different. We have take different approaches to our material, and it's a way to be entertained, to be educated, to be inspired.